What's up internet? Bibili ka ng monitor and gusto mo malaman what you need to know para hindi sayang pera mo. Pero bago nun, hindi talaga sayang pera mo kung bumili ka sa sponsor natin.
Ang video na to ay handog ni cdkoffers.com. Marami kang mahahanap na iba't ibang uri ng software dito. May games, apps, activation codes for Windows 10. Check out our video on CDK offers in the video description. Mabilis, mura, and syempre legit dito. Madali lang mag-order, search for the software you need, add to cart, check out, done ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CDK ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
First thing you need to know is about ports. And kailangan mo siguraduhin na yung available display ports dun sa computer mo, ganun din yung port nung monitor na binibili mo. For example, kung yung PC mo may VGA lang, you need to make sure that the monitor also has a VGA port. Some monitors nowadays, especially yung mas high-end, wala nang VGA. HDMI gamit niya, DisplayPort, or even DVI. And if you have, let's say, yun nga, yung computer mo VGA, yung monitor na nabili mo, HDMI lang, yes, there are converters, but they're difficult to find, paminsan di sila gumagana, sobrang nakakainis na maghanap pa ng converter. So, iwas sakit sa ulo, just make sure that the ports you have on your computer are the same ports that you have on your monitor. It sounds super basic, but you know, a lot of headaches, kahit dito sa shop, daming frustrations na, ay, HDMI lang pala tong monitor, pero yung graphics card, ano, high-end, display port lang, or things like that. Same port on the PC should also be available on the monitor. I guess sanay sila kasi ang daming ibang sinasaksak sa motherboard, yung LAN cable, yung speakers, yung input, yung mga peripherals like keyboard and mouse. So when it gets to the monitor, medyo autopilot na lang na, oh sige, ito din, saksak natin sa motherboard. But if you have a graphics card, that will not work. Kung may GPU yung computer mo, kailangan mo talaga isaksak sa GPU slot. The only time that you plug in your monitor into your motherboard is when you do not have a graphics card. So it's super easy. Kapag may graphics card, pasok mo dun sa graphics card. Kung walang graphics card, saksak mo sa monitor. Number two, ano ba itong mga ports na to? And there are different kinds of ports. You have the old VGA, you have DVI, HDMI, DisplayPort. And kagaya nung nabanggit ko dati, you need to make sure that the port on your PC is the same port as on your monitor. Usually, yung mga high-end monitors, HDMI and DisplayPort na lang yun. Because these are the ports that allow you to have higher resolutions and higher hertz. But aside from making sure that you have the correct type, so VGA to VGA, HDMI to HDMI, yung medyo nakakalito is yung HDMI at saka yung DisplayPort, iba-iba din versions nun. Pero they all fit together. Yung DisplayPort 1.3 is physically the same as DisplayPort 1. So masasaksak mo yun. Pero magkaiba performance nun. So you really need to check for HDMI tsaka for DisplayPort what the version is on your monitor and what the version is on your graphics card. Kasi ang layo talaga ng performance benefits dun sa later versions ni HDMI tsaka ni DisplayPort. For example, excited ka bumili ng monitor, naka-DisplayPort 1.3 siya. And based on your research, kaya niya na 4K at 120Hz. Pero pag uwi mo sa bahay, chinek mo yung graphics card mo, tapos medyo luma na pala siya, DisplayPort 1 lang siya. Ano yung max ni DisplayPort 1 for 4K? 30Hz lang. So yung monitor mo, DisplayPort 1.3, kaya niya 4K at 120Hz. Yung graphics card mo, DisplayPort 1, kaya niya 4K at 30Hz. Sino doon yung masusundan? It always follows the slowest. So you're only going to get yung speed ng graphics card, yung speed ng DisplayPort 1, which is 4K at 30Hz. That's why, yun nga, mahalaga na check mo rin yung version. Anong version ng HDMI na nakuha mo? Anong version ng DisplayPort? And dapat magtugma yun dun sa graphics card mo. It's okay like if DisplayPort 1.3 si graphics card and then DisplayPort 1.4 si monitor. Yun nga, will default to the slowest. yung 1.3 yung habol mo, so at least maka 4K at 120Hz ka pa rin. But just because things plug in together doesn't mean that you're getting the fastest speeds that are advertised. Kasi syempre, yung mga manufacturers, gusto nila, advertise lang nila yung pinakamabilis. Kasi usually, yung sinasabi ng mga manufacturers, yung highest rated speed lang, or kumbaga, the highest speed possible of the latest version. So kung marinig mo yung DisplayPort, and or marinig mo na, ah, DisplayPort 1.3, kaya na pala 4K at 120Hz. Pero, di nila sinasabi na kung DisplayPort 1, yung graphics card, hanggang 30Hz lang yun. So again, check the version. And that brings us to number 3, or itong mga terms na to. Ano ba tong Hertz? Ano ba tong response time? Yung Hertz, higher number, better. So 100Hz is better than 60Hz. Hertz is just the measurement of how many times your monitor can refresh in 1 second. So kung 60Hz, it's refreshing the image 60 times a second. 100Hz, 100 times a second. And so you want the higher number because the more Hertz, the more frames per second you're seeing, the smoother the gameplay is, the faster you're able to react to something that you see on screen. So gamers generally look for high Hertz monitors. Yung response time naman, and again, you see this a lot, 1 millisecond response time. It's a measurement of how long it takes for a certain pixel to change color. Dito naman, lower number, better. Because the lower the number, or kumbaga, the faster the response time, you get less issues with ghosting, with kind of blur when you move something very fast on screen. Nababawasan yung ghosting effect kung mabilis yung response time ng monitor mo. Different manufacturers measure response time differently. Sometimes it's like from gray to gray, or how fast it is to go from the entire color spectrum back to the original color. Sometimes it's just black to white. But they all measure the speed, how quick a pixel is to change color. Pero may downside din yung fast response time. Usually, hindi ganun kaganda yung colors for fast response time monitors. They're less vibrant, they're dull, they don't seem, yun nga, parang hindi sila nagpa-pop masyado. Tapos usually, less bright yung screen. So actually, kung di ka gamer, and these response times are measured in milliseconds, and it really doesn't matter kung video, kung let's say, mahilig ka manood ng video sa monitor mo, and other applications like that, response time does not matter. It's only for gamers that need to look into na, oh, gusto ko yung pinakamabilis na 1 millisecond response time. But yun nga, it comes with a drawback, which brings us to the type of panel, or number 4 na kailangan mong tutukan when you're buying a monitor. A monitor these days is usually made out of either of 3 types of panels. So there's the TN, and the TN is actually yung pinakamura na screen. TN monitors are usually the fastest when it comes to response time, so a lot of gaming monitors use them. But nandun nga yung drawbacks nung fast response time. Medyo dull yung colors, hindi ganun ka-bright yung screen. The colors, they don't pop, they're not as vibrant. The second type of panel is IPS. Yung maganda sa IPS, sobrang ganda ng color reproduction nito. These are what professionals usually buy. If you're a photographer, you need blue color correction, a videographer, artist, renderer, any application where you need to have very nice colors, very good color reproduction, usually you want to go with an IPS screen. Since maganda yung kulay nila, hindi ganun kaganda yung response time nila. They have higher response times, and yun nga, nabanggit natin, for response times, you want the lower number. Better yung lower number. But because, you know, they don't need to react as fast, IPS panels do have that very nice color gamut that a lot of people need. A lot of people, not necessarily gamers, but a lot of professionals need. And the last type of panel is the VA panel. Yung VA, it tries to be a mix of both TN and IPS. Parang it's trying to get the faster response times of the TN with the nicer color range and brightness of the IPS. So kumbaga, it's trying to be the best of both worlds. And a lot of the more high-end gaming monitors now, yung mga curved, yung mga malaki, like 34-inch, are usually TN now. And in fairness sa TN, kaya niya na mabilis. Usually mga 166Hz, 144Hz. And so these are very fast refresh rates. Yung problema lang sa VA, since it tries to be the best of both worlds, sometimes, depende sa manufacturer, depende sa panel, it also gets the worst of both worlds. Paminsan, di ganun kaganda yung color reproduction, so parang TN panel. At the same time, paminsan, hindi ganun kaganda yung response time, like an IPS panel. And that's really where we are now. The VA is sort of the compromise that a lot of the gaming monitor guys are using, in that it can give you fast refresh rates and acceptable color reproduction. But you know, there's always a trade-off. There's always a trade-off between speed and the vibrancy of the color, the brightness of the monitor. So in general, if you're looking for a nice gaming screen, you probably want a VA, but do your homework on that specific model. Tas since nasa gaming tayo, another feature of monitors is Gsync versus Freesync. Ano ba tong war of the two syncs? Both of them try to solve the same problem. Paminsan, when you're playing a game, may napapansin kang screen tearing or ripping. Like if you move, especially sa FPS, if you move the screen around, you notice na parang yung picture nahahati siya, or yun nga, may tearing or ripping on the screen. Both Gsync and FreeSync try to solve that. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card, Gsync yun. And to take advantage of Gsync, you need to have a Gsync compatible monitor. Ganun din sa AMD. If you have an AMD card, then it uses FreeSync, you need a FreeSync compatible monitor. So they both try to do the same thing, to lessen or eliminate screen tearing, or that kinda parang nagla-lag yung game kasi yung nga parang jagged na yung ano, pagka-refresh nung image on the screen. But since yun nga, magkalaban si AMD tsaka si NVIDIA, kailangan din magkalaban yung standards nila. So if you have an NVIDIA graphics card, you need to have a Gsync compatible monitor. For an AMD card, you need to have a FreeSync compatible monitor. There has been an improvement on this front. Now may tinatawag na Gsync compatible. And these are monitors na sinecertify ni NVIDIA. They're gonna say na, okay, ito talaga hindi siya Gsync rated. Pero Gsync compatible siya in the sense na we guarantee that if you use these monitors, wala kang makikita na screen artifacts. So, let's say yung monitor, hindi siya Gsync rated, pero Gsync compatible siya, pwede mo pa rin gamitin yun sa NVIDIA graphics card mo. And yun nga, NVIDIA guarantees that okay na to. They will... You won't experience screen artifacts if you use these monitors. So a slight improvement, but to be honest, it's a real pain na kung may NVIDIA graphics card ka, tapos maghahanap ka pa kung yung monitor na gusto mong bilhin, kung Gsync compatible ba yan. Sometimes the manufacturer doesn't really say so. There are unofficial lists of Gsync compatibility, pero since unofficial nga siya, you don't know how accurate they are. You need to take them with a grain of salt. So it's nice na may ganito, Gsync compatible instead of Gsync rated. Pero yun nga, you also have to do your homework if you're looking into that. Another thing about monitors is that size matters. May nakita akong advice dati na what's the best size for a gaming monitor, tapos yung payo 24 to 27 inches. Some people kasi ayaw nila 32 inches para ang lapit sa'yo, and then parang sobrang in your face ng monitor, but I disagree. I try to get the largest monitor possible for anything that I'm using. Kung that's for work, if that's for gaming, if that's for editing, whatever I need to do. Ano kaya ng budget ko? The largest size that I can get with my budget, that's what I usually go for. Because size really matters. You think it seems so small. 3 inches, ano ba yung difference ng 3 inches? 24 to 27. Ano difference ng 5 inches? 27 to 32. But baby, those inches matter. I'm talking about monitors. Size really matters when it comes to this. And your use case also comes into play. Dati na-review ko yung LG 32-inch monitor, and you can see it here. I love that monitor. It's really nice. The colors really pop. It's massive at 32 inches. Tamang-tama lang for productivity as well as gaming. And for that one, it's an IPS screen. Pero you don't mind gaming on it. And if you're just gaming like Dota or not, you know, yung mga games na hindi naman FPS, na you don't need like super fast refresh rates, then a 32 IPS monitor versus a 24-inch TN is fine. Your screen doesn't refresh that much on Dota 2. And it really makes a difference in the immersion. Ganda talaga nung size ng 32 inches. My personal monitor at home is a 24-inch gaming monitor. So I have hours and hours and hours of experience playing different games on it. But right now, if I could upgrade, I would really go with something bigger, like a 32-inch curve. My brother has a 34-inch na curve, so yeah, he can't go back anymore. Nung nasubukan na niya yung 34, di niya kaya bumalik to anything, to a smaller monitor, because yun nga, once na-try mo na yung size na yun, it's really helpful whatever you're doing on your computer. So, when people ask me, like, should I get a larger size monitor versus a smaller monitor pero mas mabilis yung response time or mas mataas yung refresh rates, yung hertz, I usually ask them what they need it for. But in general, my rule of thumb is get the largest that your budget can afford. And that brings us to our last tip. Kailangan mo rin talagang timplahan kung kaya nung computer mo yung bilis nung monitor. Yun nga, bibili ka ng 27-inch na TN na kaya mag 166Hz. Pero yung graphics card mo, for that game, kaya lang yung 60Hz. So, sayang lang din yung gastos mo dun sa mahal na monitor. Hindi mo naman nakikita yung performance gains. Or gusto mo mag 4K gaming, bumili ka ng monitor na kaya mag 4K gaming. Pero hindi naman kaya ng system mo. Kaya nga mag 4K, pero 15 frames per second. Which is unplayable. I don't care, kahit anong game yan, 15 FPS is pretty bad. Baka pwede mo papagtsagaan kung puzzle game. Pero kung FPS, you know, 15 FPS is that you might as well just not move and patayin ka na lang ng kalaban. You need to take into consideration when buying a monitor, also your system. And what kind of gaming do you want to do? 2K, 4K, 1080p? Generally now, most modern systems can comfortably do 1080p gaming between 60 to 100 Hz. That's a modern system in most games. Yung ang daming configurations ngayon, ang daming games, so it's hard to give a general, very basic numbers that can apply to everybody. But I think 1080p gaming, 60 to 100 Hz, if you're not sure what your PC can do and what game you'll be playing, that's probably the margin that you want to consider when buying a monitor. So, medyo maraming kailangang pag-isipan when buying a monitor and take your time. Kasi yung monitor, usually, matagal yan, matagal yung lifespan yan. So, kahit na outgrow mo na yung PC mo, na-upgrade mo na, or napagpalit mo ng bago, usually the monitor goes with you to the new system. At least that's what happens for me. Sobrang bihira lang ako bumili ng monitor kasi yun nga, okay pa rin sila even after 5, 6, 7 years. So it's better to slow down, don't rush, take the time to really find a monitor that fits your needs and find a monitor na yan yung mga specs na kailangan mo. We have been reviewing more monitors lately and you can check them out here. Or may series kami na paano ba bumili ng mga basic PC parts and you can see that here. So, ayun. Thanks for watching.